Have you ever wondered the difference between a portable folding panel, a flexible panel, or a glass rigid panel? Well, we're going to break that down in this video. For example, a folding panel like this is great because how compact it is. Flexible panels like this are super lightweight and are designed to be easily surface mounted. Now, if you're looking for the best durability and the best pricing, you may want to choose a glass rigid panel, but it's not portable and it's fairly heavy. One of the most common questions I get is, why would you want to choose each type of panel? So in this video, first we're going to test each panel for power output. We're going to compare that to the cost, weight, and size of the panel, and then we'll talk about the advantages and disadvantages of each panel type. The solar conditions today are excellent. It's around 60 degrees and we have very clear skies. Now each one of these panels have been sitting out in the sun for about 20 minutes, so they're all the same temperature. The first panel type that we'll be testing is the folding or portable type. This is my Eliconta 120 watt solar panel. I have angled this properly at the sun using the built-in kickstands and the can trick. So let's go ahead and see how much power we're getting from this one. In all the tests today, we'll be using my Blue Sky Energy MPPT solar charge controller, and I have the shunt here so we can see what's happening. Remember, the simple equation for wattage is volts times amps. So what we're getting from the Eliconta 120 is 16.72 volts at 6.03 amps, right around 100 watts of power. One advantage of this solar panel is it has the built-in kickstand, so you can set this up anywhere. You don't have to lean it up against something. But the other two panels that we'll be testing, the flexible and the glass rigid, they do not have kickstands, so I'll have to lean them up against the shed to test them at the proper angle. The glass rigid solar panel that we'll be testing in the video is a BougeRV 100 watt solar panel. This has the half cut cells and 9 bus bars, so it's one of their newer models. I have this one angled properly at the sun, so let's check the charge controller. So for the BougeRV 100 watt panel, we're getting 16 volts at 5.54 amps, right around 88 watts of power. The flexible solar panels that we'll be testing in the video are two of these SunPower Flex 50s. I have them wired together in parallel, so let's see how many watts we're getting on the charge controller. With the SunPower flexible solar panels, we're getting 15.44 volts at 6.18 amps, right around 95 watts of power. Now I understand that I have different wattage solar panels here. My goal is not to get an apples to apples comparison for which one gets the most power. What I want to do is take these power numbers and we're going to compare them to the price. So we're going to get a price per watt. We are going to compare it to the weight and get a watt per pound number. And also we're going to compare it to the square footage. So we're going to get a watt per square foot. And this will help us determine the advantages and disadvantages of each one of these solar panels. So let's go ahead and take all this information, put it through a couple of different equations and break it down. So on the screen, you'll see the results for the Eliconta 120 folding solar panel. The output we tested was 100 watts, or 83% of the rated output. This panel is currently priced at $169, so at that price, you pay $1.69 per watt produced. The weight of the solar panel is 9.8 pounds, so you get around 10.2 watts per pound. The folded size is 20 inches by 15 inches, or only 2.1 square feet, or 47 watts per square foot. Now this is a big advantage for this panel because it folds up so small. Breaking down the results for the BougeRV 100 watt glass solar panel, the output we measured was 88 watts or 88% of the rated output. It's also the most affordable panel priced at $79, so you pay 89 cents per watt. It is a little bit heavier than the Eliconta 120. It weighed in at 13 pounds, so you get 6.7 watts per pound. Now the size is also larger. It's 21 by 39 inches or 5.6 square feet, which is 15 watts per square foot. Now for the SunPower Flex 50s in parallel, we measured 95 watts or 95% of the rated output. They are currently priced at $148, so you'll pay around $1.55 per watt. These are the lightest weight panels. They only weigh 5.2 pounds together, so you do get an advantage of 18 watts per pound on these. The stored size, because they are paper thin, they just stack right on top of each other. It's 22 inches by 26 inches or 3.9 square feet, which is 24 watts per square foot. Now in the beginning of the video, we briefly talked about what each one of these panels are. And in the next section of the video, I want to talk about the use cases, the disadvantages and advantages of each one. The first panel that we'll talk about is the folding or portable panel. The biggest advantage of this panel is the space that it takes up. It is much smaller than the other two options, but still deploys out and provides the same amount of power. So if you're tight on storage space, then this is a great option. So let's go through some of the use cases. When I go camping, I like to have a 12 volt fridge and some other devices that I run off a battery or power station. And I like to use these because I like to be in the shade and I like all my gear in the shade, but that's not good for solar. So I have these out on an extension cable, charging around camp. The great thing about a portable panel like this is you can just pick it up, move it around, and set it up as the sun moves. Because if you've been in the forest, you know that as the sun goes through the sky, the shade is always changing. And so a lightweight, small panel like this with kickstands is a really good way to charge up your gear. So that's one use case to use these while camping. Another great use case is if you have an RV or a trailer and you have solar panels on the top, but you're getting a bunch of shade on that because it's just where your trailer is parked. You can have a few of these stored away in the storage cabinets and you can pull them out, connect them up and put them in areas where around camp where it's sunny and you can still get supplemental power into your batteries. The final use case for a panel like this would probably be for emergency backup. Say you live in an HOA where you can't have solar panels in your yard or on your house or some other situation where you just don't have room for solar. Maybe you live in an apartment or something like that. You can store these away inside your house. And if you have the power go out, you can deploy these out, hang them on your balcony, set them up in your yard, and charge up your batteries so that you can keep your house and important things going during a power outage. You can easily get 400 to 600 watts of these and deploy them around your yard, hang them on your balcony, and get that power so that you can keep your devices running during a power outage. Now, some of the disadvantages to a panel like this, well, is the price. They are much more expensive. And I think that has to go to the fabrication process. Instead of just a machine, popping out, solar panels, this requires someone to sew it together, the additional time, things like that. And that's where I think the manufacturing cost is increased on these models. The other downside to a panel like this is probably the durability. If you think about how this works is you have individual panels that are connected together along these seams. And as you fold it back and forth, there are wires in between here that will eventually degrade and break down. The other thing is that this is a fabric panel and it has plastic coating. So they're not really meant to be used all day, every single day. Most of these panels are not fully waterproof. We have seen more of these folding and portable panels that are waterproof. This one's just water resistant. On the back, there is a pocket that's not supposed to get wet. So you do have to put these away most of the time if you're going to have a big rainstorm or, if you have a windstorm or something like that, they're gonna blow around. They do have anchors that I've reviewed on the channel where you can anchor these down in the wind, which is nice, but you do have to purchase an additional accessory to do that. I really like these. I think they have their use case. So if you have one of these and you use it in a specific way that I didn't mention, throw a comment down below. I'd love to get your guys' feedback on how you use a folding or portable solar panel. So let's go ahead and talk about flexible solar panels. So why would you want to use this or where would you use this? Well, if you look at this, this is designed to be a surface mount solar panel. Everything is on the front of the solar panel, so you can mount it to the top of your RV, your boat, or your trailer. The other thing that's a benefit is because they are slightly flexible, you have the ability to contour the roof that you're mounting them to. They are not meant to be folded beyond a certain point, and they are not meant to be stepped on, so keep that in mind when you're using these panels. The easiest way to install these is to use a double-sided sticky tape or VHB tape and just mount them down, and then you are good to go. You don't have to drill into the top of your roof or anything like that. That's why a lot of people choose to use these flexible panels. They do have eyelets on the corner, so you can mount them that way. Maybe you can hang them up on the side of some sort of structure or roof or balcony. I love that these are so lightweight. Like, each one weighs like 2.5 pounds, guys. They're super, super lightweight. Flexible panels also have waterproof junction boxes and MC4 connections, so they are fully waterproof. The other advantage to these panels is they are a little bit cheaper than the folding or portable solar panels in most cases. These are a little bit older, the SunPower Flex 50s. You can see that I'm still getting full rated power from them. They have a PET coating. So the PET coating on these is not meant to be a super durable, long-lasting application. I wouldn't expect more than 5 years out of a PET coated solar panel, but a lot of the newer panels that I've seen, including the ones that I have outside my Renogy 1000 watt array, they have an ETFE coating that will last a lot longer. In fact, it's been out for 8 months in every single day use case, rain, snow, shine,
and they are still getting full rated power, and I'm not seeing any degradation or discoloring of those solar panels. So there are many different use cases for these. For example, my father-in-law has four of these. He uses them as a camping solar panel because they're just so lightweight, and he has put them on a PVC frame so that they're a little bit more rigid as you stand them up. And basically, as they get warm, they kind of bend like this if they're up against something. So you do have to have some sort of frame or backer on these if you want them to stay rigid as they heat up. If you use a flexible panel, let me know down in the comments section how you use it, because there are so many different applications. But I love how lightweight they are. I love that they're waterproof, and the technology is getting better and better on these every single day. Now, the last panel type that we'll talk about, but definitely not the least, is the glass rigid panel. So why would you want to choose this type of panel? Well, if you're looking for the ultimate durability, longevity, and pricing, a glass rigid panel is the way to go. Let's break down durability. For example, this has an aluminum frame, so it's very strong. It has a tempered glass front, which can handle pretty much any weather type. The only weather type I think would be an issue is a large hailstorm, but snow, wind, rain, not an issue for this solar panel. Now, on the back of the solar panel, you have a waterproof junction box and MC4 connections. So you just don't even have to think twice about leaving this out in any type of weather condition. Now, what about longevity? Because this has a glass front, it's not going to be UV damaged over time like the flexible or folding or portable solar panels. Those PET and ETFE coatings will not last as long as a glass front solar panel. Now, what about pricing? Well, these are priced really well. Now, this example of this one on the table here is a 12 volt consumer grade solar panel, so it does have a higher price. This one's $79, and so that's 79 cents per watt. The more wattage that you get, and if you step up to residential or commercial grade solar panels, they are much more affordable. For example, I put out a video a couple of weeks ago showing you guys where you could find really, really good deals locally on 400 watt solar panels. So I'll include that video down in the video description if you want to check that out. The other advantage to a solar panel like this is the technology that's inside of it. You're going to get the bypass diodes, the half cut cells, the high bus bar counts. You're going to get really efficient solar cells. So usually you have the latest and greatest technology in a glass rigid solar panel. Now, what about some disadvantages to this solar panel? Well, it's big and it's heavy. They're hard to store. Trust me, I have an issue storing these in my yard and around the place. It's just hard to store these because I'm not using a bunch because I have a YouTube channel. The other disadvantage is moving them around. Now, yes, this 100 watt panel is 13 pounds. You can store this away for camping. You can move it around pretty easily, but step up to a 200, 300 or 400 watt solar panel, they're getting up to like 50 or 60 pounds. Lugging that thing around, you know, in a portable setup is not ideal. So just keep in mind, these are not meant for portability or, you know, ease of storage. Now, one last disadvantage to a panel like this is that it requires mounting hardware. So if you're going to put this on your RV or trailer, shed, or some sort of outbuilding or your house, you will have to purchase the rails and the mounting hardware, which adds to the total cost of your system. Now, it's been fun to cover the advantages and disadvantages of each one of these panels. And if someone tells you that you should only use one type of solar panel, they have failed logic. I've showed you guys in this video that certain panels are really good for certain things and some panels are not. So you have to use the solar panel for its specific use case. For example, camping, these ones work really good. But if you're looking for home backup, then you're going to want to go with a glass rigid solar panel. If you want to mount something to the top of your RV and just stick it down with tape, then a flexible panel is a great way to go. So hopefully you guys have found this information helpful. If you did like the video, please smash the thumbs up button, share it with your friends and family. And also, I'm gonna throw a few graphs up about all the information that we found out when we tested this. And then after that, I'll recommend a few videos that you guys can check out to learn more about solar. I absolutely love solar. It's completely addictive, and hopefully you guys like it too. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video.